हेलो, एम आई ऑडिबल?
Yes, you are.
ओके, गुड इवनिंग. माई सेल्फ चांदनी. दिस फाइन इवनिंग वी हैव द एकॉ फाउंडेशन इनिशिएटेड ए न्यू लेक्चर सीरीज विद एमिनेंट स्पीकर्स फ्रॉम डिफरेंट डिसिप्लिन्स. आई एम श्योर संडे स्पार्क विल डेफिनेटली फुलफिल योर नॉलेज एंड कनेक्ट यू विद एक्सपर्ट्स. At the outset, I take this opportunity to introduce Dr. Vinci Mary Varghese, Assistant Professor, Department of Biochemistry and Microbiology, St. Bertram's College, Changanashiri. Dr. Vinci Mary Varghese has about 10 years teaching experience in the field, earned doctoral degree from Mahatma Gandhi University, Kottayam, on environmental science in 2015. Dr. Vinci Mary Varghese has published papers in international journals. She also presented papers in national and international conferences and has more than 150 Google Scholar citations. So indeed, we are very glad to have Dr. Vinci Mary Varghese, Madam, with us to share her vast knowledge. So welcome you, ma'am, for the session. Audience, make sure that their microphones are muted for better hearing. Thank you.
Thank you, Chantani. A very good evening to all the participants. Is the screen visible?
No, ma'am, it's not.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
The topic for the day is Good in the Worst, COVID-19 Restrictions and Ease in Global Air Pollution. COVID-19 pandemic is the defining global health crisis of our time and the greatest challenge we have faced since the Second World War. But the pandemic is much more than a health crisis. It displayed an unprecedented socio-economic crisis. Stressing every one of the countries it touches, it has the potential to create devastating social, economic, and political effects that will leave deep and long-standing scars. From the beginning, we have been speaking about the negative impacts of COVID-19 pandemic. But in this session, we'll be focusing on the positive impacts of COVID-19 pandemic on the environment. The World Health Organization says the physiological requirement of an average adult is roughly 14 kg of air, 1.5 kg of food, and 2 kg of water per day. It has been observed that a healthy person can live for 5 days without food and water, but only for 5 minutes without air. It is therefore essential that we must be acquainted with the air around us and the major sources accountable for air pollution. Discussing on the composition of atmospheric gases, according to NASA, the gases in Earth's atmosphere are categorized into major components, minor components, and trace gases. Nitrogen with 78% and oxygen with 21%. Annually, 4.6 million people die worldwide due to poor air quality. Air pollution is a global problem and its effects can be seen even across developed nations such as Europe, where 1,93,000 people died due to air pollution in 2012. According to Greenpeace, 95% of the people in the world breathe. Discussing about air pollution, it is defined as the presence or introduction of substances into the atmosphere, which causes detrimental effects on man, animals, plants, or property, if present in concentrations exceeding their normal ambient levels. The classification of air pollutants are based on source, mode of release, chemical composition, and size of pollutants. Based on the source, air pollutants are classified into primary and secondary pollutants. On the basis of mode of release, they are categorized into indoor and outdoor pollutants, and based on the chemical composition and size, pollutants are grouped as particulate matter and gaseous pollutants. Comparing primary pollutants and secondary pollutants, primary pollutants are those emitted into the environment from a source. Secondary pollutants are the result of interactions of primary pollutants with other atmospheric molecules. The sources of air pollutants, we have two sources, mainly natural sources and anthropogenic sources. Natural sources include volcanic eruption. The volcanic gases which pose the greatest potential hazards are water vapor, sulfur dioxide, carbon dioxide, hydrogen sulfide, and hydrogen halides. Dust storms lead to significant changes in the wind speed, temperature, and patterns of vertical transport of atmospheric parameters, altering the concentration of some greenhouse and trace gases that may be detrimental to the air quality. Photochemical reaction is caused due to photochemical oxidation of hydrocarbons and oxides of nitrogen. Sea spray refers to aerosol particles that are formed directly from the ocean. Marshall lands release methane, carbon dioxide, and hydrogen sulfides. Radioactive emissions from rock. The primary sources of natural radioactivity in the rock and soil are radionuclides of the elements such as uranium, thorium, and potassium, and the radio elements such as uranium-238, thorium-232, and potassium-40. Forest fires are another natural causes of air pollution. A wide variety of pollutants are released during forest fire, include greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, photochemically reactive compounds like carbon monoxide, oxides of nitrogen, and particulate matter. Forest fire hazards are the recent trend occurring all over the world. More than 11 million hectares of bush, forest, and parks across Australia was burnt, and over 50 hectares of land was destroyed by forest fire in Uttarakhand. The slide shows fire accidents between 2010 and 2014, which killed approximately 1.13 lakh people. Coming to the anthropogenic sources, the anthropogenic sources include vehicular emissions, aquatic agricultural activities, thermal power plant, burning of fossil fuels, smoking, exhausts from industries, waste incineration, military activities and nuclear explosions, mining operations, and construction and demolition. Discussing the vehicular air pollution, the automobile industry in India is the fifth largest, with the country currently being the world's fourth largest manufacturer of cars and the seventh largest manufacturer of commercial vehicles in 2018. A typical passenger vehicle emits about 4.6 metric tons of carbon dioxide per year. The figure shows ranking of countries in the manufacture of cars and commercial vehicles, China at the topmost position. The graph shows carbon dioxide emission from ships and national car fleets in Europe for the year 2019. Here we have the emissions from different modes of transport. This data shows India at the topmost position in carbon emissions from electric cars. Here we notice the range of life cycle of carbon dioxide emission from different vehicles and fuel types. Coming to the burning of fossil fuels include coal, oil, and natural gas. According to U.S. Energy Information Administration, the burning of fossil fuels was responsible for 76% of U.S. greenhouse gas emission in 2016. The U.S. leads the world in petroleum consumption at 19.88 million barrels per day as per 2017 records. China is the global leader in coal production, responsible for 48% of the world's supply. The U.S. produces around 17.6% of the world's natural gas and consumes about 21.6% of it. Contribution of fossil fuels to greenhouse gas emission in U.S. contributing coal with 30%, natural gas 27%, and petroleum with 43%. The global carbon emissions from fossil fuels show a rapidly increasing trend from 1900 to 2014. The table shows carbon emission from thermal power plants. The study makes a comparison between the combustion of imported coal and natural gas. Greenhouse gas emissions from the agricultural sectors as per 2017. The percentage contribution of agricultural activities to the world carbon dioxide equivalent emissions from all human activities was 20%. Agricultural accounted for 42% of the total methane and 75% of the total nitrous oxide emissions. A contribution of 11% from crop and livestock activities and an additional 9% from the land use patterns. Agricultural shares of regional and world total carbon dioxide equivalent emission for the year 2017. The graph shows the contribution of agriculture, crops and livestock, and agricultural land use patterns in the world and in various continents. Discussing the consequences of air pollution, it includes increase in greenhouse gases, rise in temperature, acid rain, ozone depletion, deforestation, photochemical smog, global warming, climate change, rise in sea level, loss of biodiversity. Greenhouse gases. A greenhouse gas is a gas that absorbs and emits radiant energy within the thermal infrared range. Greenhouse gases cause greenhouse effect on the planets. The major greenhouse gases are carbon dioxide, methane, ground level ozone, water vapor, chlorofluorocarbon, and nitrous oxide. According to EPA greenhouse gas emission 2018, carbon dioxide with 80%, methane 10%, fluorinated gases 3%, and nitrous oxide 7%. The disadvantages of greenhouse gas effect include very warm summers with natural disasters, water balance get disturbed, life and ecosystem get disturbed, the change in weather pattern, rainfall will become erratic in many parts of the world. Human lives and world economy suffering. Rise in temperature reduces the global output by 2 to 3%. This is an image of an island in Maldives, which was previously a tourist spot. Now this has been disappeared due to the rise in sea level. It only leaves a boat. Welcome to Maldives. Kyoto Protocol. It's an international treaty which extends the 1992 United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change to reduce the greenhouse gas emission. The Kyoto Protocol has listed 6 greenhouse gases in Annex A, which include carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, perfluorocarbons, hydrofluorocarbons, and sulfur hexafluoride. Next, impacts of air pollution include global warming and climate change. Global warming is a long-term heating of Earth's climate system observed since the pre-industrial period due to human activities, primarily burning of fossil fuels, which increases the heat trapping greenhouse gas levels in the Earth's atmosphere. Climate change is a global warming plus large-scale shift in weather patterns, which are caused by increasing temperatures driven by human since the Industrial Revolution. This resulted in the melting of glaciers and sea level rise. Ozone depletion is another major environmental problem because it increases the amount of ultraviolet radiation that reaches the Earth's surface. It resulted in a steady lowering of about 4% in the total amount of ozone in the Earth's atmosphere and a much larger springtime decrease in the stratospheric ozone around the Earth's polar region. The ozone depleting gases include chlorofluorocarbons, hydrofluorocarbons, halons, methyl bromide, carbon tetrachloride, bromofluoromethane, methyl chloroform, etc. Ozone depletion in man results in cataract and skin cancer, and moreover, it impairs the genetic and immune system of humans. It also affects agriculture, forestry, and destroys the natural ecosystem. These impacts led to the signing up of the Montreal Protocol. It is Montreal Protocol on substances that deplete the ozone layer. It is an international treaty signed to protect the ozone layer, signed on 26 August 1987, and the world celebrates Ozone Day on September 16. A significant reduction in the consumption of ozone depleting substances have been achieved by the European 1986. This reduction has largely been driven by the 1987 Montreal Protocol. You can visualize the false color view of the total ozone over the Antarctic poles. The purple and blue color are regions where there is least ozone, and the yellow and red colors are with more ozone. So this is the image in the year 2006, September, and 2020 September. So there has been a change. You can notice a change, that is, there is an increasing ozone layer in 2020. Acid rain is a rain or any other form of precipitation that is unusually acidic, meaning that it has elevated levels of hydrogen ions. And it has harmful effects on plants, aquatic animals, and infrastructures. This is an image which shows the impact of acid rain on different famous monuments all over the world. Photochemical smoke. It is a haze in the atmosphere accompanied by high levels of ozone and oxides of nitrogen caused by the action of sunlight on pollutants. Toxic to the humans, and it even causes severe sickness, shortening of the lifespan, and premature death. The Great Smoke of 1952 darkened the streets of London and killed approximately 4,000 people in a short time of 4 days. The effects of air pollution falls on plants, animals, humans, and infrastructures. Effects of air pollutants on plants: bleaching of leaves and necrosis due to sulfur dioxide, necrosis at the leaf tip due to nitrogen dioxide, suppressed growth and bleaching due to ozone, suppressed growth and silvering of the lower leaf surfaces due to the presence of fluorides, and suppressed growth and bleaching, necrosis, collapse of the leaf due to pan. The effect of air pollutants on plants results in symptomatical appearances known as necrosis and chlorosis. Necrosis is death of the cells or tissues, and the symptoms appear in the form of dark spots on the leaves, which may later turn black. Chlorosis is the yellowing of the normally green leaves due to a lack of chlorophyll. The effects of air pollutants on animals include acidic rivers and streams, which causes respiratory distress in fish. Small fluctuations in air quality forces certain insects to relocate, affecting the other plants and animals. Fluoride and heavy metals accumulating in the soil and pose toxicity to the soil invertebrates. Some birds like osprey find it difficult in living around acidic lakes due to the scarcity of fish fauna. Mollusks and crustaceans are another group of organisms which are very sensitive to the pH levels and are among the first to disappear during acidification of wetland systems. The effects of air pollutants on animals include corals, larval forms, mollusks, fishes, birds, mammals, and even invertebrates. The effect of air pollutants on human: it is visualized that nearly all the body systems in man is affected due to the exposure to air pollution. Here I have given the various disorders and symptoms which are visualized due to the exposure of air pollutants in humans. I have a video for you.
Air pollution consists of chemicals or particles in the atmosphere that pose serious health and environmental threats. But what causes air pollution, and what does it mean for our planet? Some air pollution comes from natural sources like volcanic eruptions, wildfires, or allergens. But most air pollution results from human activities, such as energy use and agriculture. There are different types of human-made air pollution. When we burn fossil fuels to produce energy, they released greenhouse gases into the air. These emissions, such as carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, and fluorinated gases, trap heat from the sun in Earth's atmosphere, leading to a rise in global temperatures. This creates a cycle where air pollution contributes to climate change, and climate change creates higher temperatures. In turn, higher temperatures intensify some types of air pollution. For example, climate change increases smog because it forms in the presence of high heat and increased levels of ultraviolet radiation. More frequent extreme weather, such as flooding, contributes to damp conditions and therefore to a rise in mold. Warmer weather also leads to longer pollen seasons and therefore more pollen production. Smog is a type of air pollution that reduces visibility and has serious health effects. Smog can be divided into two categories, sulfurous and photochemical. Sulfurous smog is made up of chemical compounds called sulfur oxides. It occurs when burning sulfur-bearing fossil fuels such as coal. Photochemical smog, also called ground-level ozone, is a result of the reaction between sunlight, nitrogen oxides, and volatile organic compounds. Nitrogen oxides come from car exhaust, coal power plants, and factory emissions. Volatile organic compounds are released from gasoline, paints, and many cleaning solvents. Smog not only creates the brown haze that reduces visibility, but also harms plants, irritates the eyes, and causes respiratory distress. Another category of air pollution is toxic pollutants. These are chemicals such as mercury, lead, dioxins, and benzene that are released during gas or coal combustion, waste incineration, or burning of gasoline. In addition to adverse environmental effects, toxic air pollution can cause serious health problems such as cancer, reproductive complications, and birth defects. While air pollution has many consequences for our planet, there are solutions. We can limit toxic pollutants, smog, and greenhouse gases by decreasing the use of fossil fuels, such as in transportation, manufacturing, and electricity generation. Reducing air pollution not only contributes to a cleaner environment and better human health, but can also slow the rate of global warming.
Is the presentation visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So the video which you saw, it was the consequences of air pollution, which we discussed in the above section, and these led to the necessity of increasing the amount of air pollutions. the National Ambient Air Quality Standards, which was established by the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency under the authority of the Clean Air Act. The Clean Air Act classified the standards into primary standards and secondary standards. The primary standards are designed to protect the health of sensitive populations such as asthma patients, children, and the elderly people. Secondary standards are concerned with protecting the environment. They are designed to address visibility, damage to crops, vegetation, buildings, and animals. The National Ambient Air Quality Standards have been set for six principal pollutants, such as criteria air pollutants, which are known as six CAPS. The table shows National Ambient Air Quality Standards, which was published by the Central Pollution Control Board in 18 November 2008. So this has released the ambient standards for the air pollutants. The air quality index is another measure to understand the quality of air. An air quality index is used to communicate to the public how polluted the air currently is and how polluted it is forecast to become. As the air quality index rises, the public health risk also rises. Different countries have their own air quality indices corresponding to different national air quality standards. For example, the air quality index levels can be classified into good, moderate, unhealthy for sensitive groups, unhealthy, very unhealthy, and hazardous. Good category includes a value between 0 to 50, moderate 51 to 100, unhealthy for sensitive groups 101 to 150, unhealthy for 151 to 200, very unhealthy 201 to 300, hazardous 301 to 500. And the color for the specific levels of air quality indexes: green color for good, yellow for moderate, orange color for unhealthy for sensitive groups, unhealthy for red, then purple color for very unhealthy, and maroon color for the hazardous group. Now coming to the second section of the topic, we come to discuss about the global lockdown. As countries went into lockdown, the industrial activities shut down globally. Among many other sectors, transport is the most hard hit sector due to lockdown. According to reports, air travel dropped by 96% due to COVID-19. And this was the lowest in 75 years. Industrial and manufacturing sector was heavily affected by the pandemic. Global oil demand declined drastically and the prices cut down sharply. COVID-19 had severe negative impacts on the human health and world economy. However, it also resulted in pollution reduction due to the limited social and economic activities. The pollution assessment during COVID-19 resulted in reduced transportation, less energy consumption, lowered oil demand. The graph shows there was a drastic traffic reduction during the lockdown period in selected cities during March 2020 in different countries. The mobility in selected cities between March 3 and August 18, 2020 is shown in this figure, and the results are compared with the movement prior to the coronavirus outbreak. You can witness a sharp decline in the weekly flight frequency of the global airlines during a period January 6 to August 30, 2020. There was again automobile sale in different countries during the lockdown period. These resulted in 20 to 30% reduction in the nitrogen dioxide emissions, which substantiated the above graphs. This table shows the mobility index report based on Google tracking. So there was a reduction in transport, grocery and pharmacy, retail and recreation, workplace, parks and outing, but there was drastic increase in the residential sectors. These are maps showing the population levels in China for a period 2019 and 2020. So the map indicates that there has been a sharp decrease in the level of pollution due to the coronavirus pandemic lockdown. Pollution levels of nitrogen dioxide for a period of 2019 and 2020 was observed in different countries like China, South Korea, Italy, UK, France, and Spain. The lifting of lockdown restrictions led to rise in pollution levels again. This is the pollution level according to the US Air Quality Index for September 5, that is yesterday. India stands first, that is Mumbai with 161, and Jakarta at the second position, Lahore at third position. So after the lockdown restrictions are lifted up, the pollution levels are slowly increasing. Coming to the lockdown period in India, the Indian scenario shows the India state level disease burden initiative collaborators in India suggest that one out of every 8 death in 2017 was associated with air pollution, and it was the second major cause to infection load after undernourishment in 2016. According to the World Air Quality Report 2018, 22 cities of India are among the world top 30 most polluted cities. Recently, it was estimated that 6,45,000 premature deaths in India occurs every year. The direct cause of environmental damage associated with the regional air pollution exceeds $0.5 trillion in India. The World Air Quality Report of 2019 shows Ghaziabad the most polluted city in the world, followed by Houghton in China, Gujranwala and Faisalabad in Pakistan, and again, Delhi in the fifth place. These are the most polluted cities for the year 2018 and 2019. So you can clearly understand that most of the Indian cities are at the topmost ranking among the most polluted cities globally. taking into consideration about the Indian cities, New Delhi. Delhi is considered among the most polluted mega cities of the globe based on environmental performance index, according to the World Health Organization 2016. Delhi ranks high in the list of particulate matter pollution in 2011 and 2016, according to the WHO 2018 reports. Particulate matter concentration is recorded very high, and it is beyond the tolerable limits as per national ambient air quality standards. During the lockdown period, that is, this is a data for the period from March 3rd to April 14, 2020, this shows a reduction in the greenhouse gas emissions in the city, New Delhi. And the graph also indicates the same, that there is a gradual and a sharp decrease in most of the air pollutants during the lockdown period. And it has shown a comparison of the lockdown period as well as with the pre-lockdown periods. These are the maps showing the impact of different air pollutants. All the maps indicate a reduction in various air pollutant factors like particulate matter, nitrogen dioxide, carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide, ammonia, but except in the case of ozone. There was an increase in the ozone concentration, especially in the industrial and transport dominated regions, which is due to the decrease of nitrogen oxides, which led to the lowering of the ozone consumption. This shows a reduction in the nitrogen dioxide emissions in Mumbai and Delhi for a period of first 4 months of 2020. So there is also a reduction. You can clearly visualize there is a reduction in the emission of nitrogen dioxide. This is the air quality index parameters, particulate matter, sulfur dioxide and nitrogen dioxide in the cities Lucknow and Delhi before and after the lockdown period. Here also we can see a gradual decrease. The sales for two-wheelers and four-wheelers has also dropped during the COVID-19 lockdown in India. This is the present air quality index for India as per June 2nd, 2020. Change in air quality before and after lockdown can be visualized in major cities of India. I have a second video, please wait. Is the slide visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next, today I would like to bring your attention towards an important factor. Is air pollution responsible for the increase in mortality due to COVID-19? Total cases reported and death rate during COVID-19 in various countries as per September 5, 2020 has been shown in this table. So the countries USA, India, Spain, UK, France, Italy, and China are among the most polluted countries, and itself shows high rate of COVID-19 cases, and the death rate also is very high in these countries. According to the World Health Organization Health Report 2020, persons of any age who suffer from severe underlying medical conditions are at a higher risk of getting critically sick from COVID-19. Certain preconditions, including lung cancer, respiratory or cardiovascular disorders, are triggered by air pollution, and the residents of region with high levels of particulate matter before the corona pandemic are more vulnerable to the infection in comparison to patients in clear parts of the world. Persons immunocompromised due to conditions like smoking or cancer are more susceptible to coronavirus infection. A research conducted in 2003 shows that SARS epidemic in China highlighted that high mortality in areas with deteriorating air quality. With these, we can say high rate of mortality is observed in regions with highly deteriorating air quality. Now, what are the control strategies for air pollution? Controlling air pollution by devices, afforestation, construction of high stock chimneys to discharge the pollutants at a higher altitudes, implementation of laws, creating public awareness. The controlling devices include wet scrubber, fabric filter, cyclone separator, gravity settling chambers, and electrostatic precipitators. The green belt formation can include by planting trees like Mangifera indica, Ficus bendensilensis, Tremolenia catapa, etc., and shrubs like Tecoma stans, Landana camara, Bougainvillea spectabilis, and grasses like Saccharum spondaneum, Cynodon ductylon, etc. Now, coming to the implementation of laws, the enforcement of Air Pollution Control Act 1981, Air Prevention and Control of Pollution Act came into force from 16 May 1981 by the Government of India. And the objective was to prevention, control, and abatement of air pollution in order to preserve the quality of air, and also to formulate the standards for quality of air. We have a National Green Tribunal Act 2010. It is an act of the Parliament of India which enables creation of a special tribunal to handle the expeditious disposal of the cases pertaining to environmental issues. It draws inspiration from the India's constitutional provision of Article 21, which leads with the protection of life and personal liberty, which assures the citizens of India the right for a healthy environment. The National Green Tribunal was established on October 18, 2010 under the National Green Tribunal Act 2010. The objective was to provide a specialized forum for effective and speedy disposal of cases pertaining to the environment protection, conservation of forest and seeking compensation for damages caused to people or property due to violation of environmental laws or conditions specified while granting permission. The structure of the National Green Tribunal include the principal bench at New Delhi, central zone at Bhopal, western zone in Pune, southern zone in Chennai, and the eastern zone in Kolkata. The power of the National Green Tribunal is to hear all the civil cases relating to environmental issues and questions that are linked to the implementation of laws listed in the Schedule 1 of National Tribunal Green Tribunal Act. And the following acts are considered under this. There is a green bench. The Supreme Court of India has directed all the High Courts of India to set up a green bench to deal environmental affairs. Green bench deals with the environmental related cases and is responsible for maintaining the equilibrium of the ecosystem. The industries identified by the Ministry of Environment and Forest and Climate Change, Government of India, under the Central Action Plan, has characterized the industry under red, orange, and green. Red with highly polluted industries, moderately polluting industries under the orange, and non-generating process effluents, and those which are not coming under red or orange category under the green category. The penalty against offenders include imprisonment for a period of 3 months or a fine of ₹5,000 or both. In the case of continuing violations, an additional fine extending to ₹1,000 per day. Major initiatives taken for air pollution control in India include vehicular technology improvement, which include using of compressed natural gas, which reduced the carbon monoxide emission to 80% and hydrocarbons to 44% in comparison to the gasoline powered vehicles, and usage of four stroke engines, which produces less pollution. Secondly, improvement in fuel quality. India has reduced the diesel sulfur content from 2,500 ppm to 50 ppm in 13 major metropolitan cities. This is the graph showing the evolution of diesel fuel quality in India for a period of 1999 and 2012. The improvement in fuel quality includes the lead content of various environmental components has decreased in response to the replacement of leaded petrol by unleaded petrol. Development of green clean technology or pollution prevention technology introduces the world's largest solar park, which was launched in March 2018 in Karnataka. Then investments in India in the sectors of wind and solar power has increased, and Renew Power has finalized a deal to acquire Astro Energy. Then what are the alternatives for controlling air pollutions? That is to stepping on to renewable energy sources like solar energies, wind power, biomass and geothermal. Then changes in vehicle systems include using of hybrid vehicles, fuel vehicles or electric vehicles. This figure shows the installation of giant lungs to indicate air pollution control in metropolitan cities of India. This is a part of public awareness programs, and the giant lungs installed in New Delhi shows a change or the darkening of the lungs within 6 days, which indicates the high level of pollution in the metropolitan city. This map shows the installation of giant lungs in Delhi, Bengaluru, Lucknow, and Nagpur. There are so many websites where one can monitor the current air quality index of any region in the world. Another public awareness program include the celebration of World and another. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
The world and celebrating the World Environmental Day, that is June 5th. And last year, the World Environmental Day theme was Beat Air Pollution. And surprisingly, this was hosted by China. As we know, China is one of the countries which is high in pollution creating globally. And they were asked to host the World Environmental Day with the title Beating Air Pollution. When thinking air pollution or when linking air pollution with COVID-19, it made me think what is common between COVID-19 and air pollution. It's wearing a mask. And concluding, COVID-19 is a global pandemic and a serious threat to human health, which halt the economic activities. However, it has also considered as a blessing in disguise, where pollution is reducing and nature is reclaiming itself. The positive impact on environment may be temporary, but the governments and individuals should learn from this lockdown on how to